Hi guys, this is René Molenaar for GNS Threefold, and I want to show you how you can solve the IP version 6.6.2.4 tunneling lab. So what we have are three routers, PIM, PAM, PET, and we're going to set up a tunnel between PIM and PET, and it should be a 6.2.4 tunnel. So let's see what we have. First of all, let's see if we have connectivity. And what I'm going to do is set up OSPF so our IP version 4 is okay. So we at least have a little bit of reachability. And we'll do it like this. There you go. Router PIM and PET, they both have a loopback, and the idea is that we can reach those loopbacks by going through the tunnel. We are not going to use router PAM, and what we should do is set up a tunnel between PIM and PET. Now let's see what we need for this. And let me tell you, if you use 6.2.4 tunneling, you need to convert your IP version 4 address of the source interface into hexadecimal and put it in the tunnel interface. And there's something you can use for this, which is the general prefix command. So you just specify which interface you want, and it will automatically convert your address into a IP version 6 tunnel address. So this is what we are going to use. Make sure you set the correct tunnel mode. And we need to make sure that we route all the everything that starts with 2002, which is the range for the tunnels. We're going to send it into the tunnel interface. Here we go. Now we need to do the same thing on this router. Let me just show you this command. IP version 6, prefix 6.2.4. And here you go. Let's create that static. Now this should be it. So let's see if we can ping the other side. So let's copy this one. And as you can see, I can ping this address. So it seems that my tunnel is working properly. So that's great. Now the second step, ensure you can ping each other's loopback interface on router PIM and PET through the tunnel interface. So what we need to do is set up a another static route. And let's do it like this. So IP version 6 route. We need to get to this prefix. We need to get through the tunnel interface. Let's see if this is working or not. And it's not working. Okay, I'm being stupid here. This is something very important. If you use a 6-to-4 tunnel, if you create a static route, you shouldn't specify the tunnel interface, but the IP address of the other side. So let's get rid of this one. And let's create the correct static that we need. I need to make sure that I point it towards this IP address. There we go. And let's check this one as well. There we go. So now I can ping the loopback. And this one is working as well. So make sure if you do a 6-to-4 tunnel, you need to specify the IP address of the tunnel on the other side as the destination for your static route. And this was the last task that we had. So this is how you can configure 6-to-4 tunneling. I hope you enjoyed this. Make sure you also check out the other tunneling techniques that we have for IPv6, because I have all of those in the IPv6 section. We got IZTAP, tunneling over IPv4, and we also have a network address translating lab. For now, thanks for watching.